Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. This is episode 6 of the 120 days to Jump Chemistry with Flash Isaac. After separation of mixtures and purification of chemical substances, JAMP wants you to know chemical combination. And what does JAMP want you to know under chemical combination? The first is stoichiometry. Stoichiometry is the nightmare of 98% of chemistry students. In fact, if someone says chemistry is difficult, there is high chance that it is because of stoichiometry. The good news is that the Flash is always here for you. Your own is to pay attention, watch, get the app, follow the questions, do your assignments, and you become so big in chemistry. Yes. Stoichiometry tries to tell us or try to compare what is and what should be. This will make sense to you later when I am analyzing stoichiometry. Then JAMP expects you to know the laws of chemical combination. Remember, I told you that the unit of matter is atoms. And this thing has billions and billions and billions of atoms. They don't exist independently. Because of their reactivity, they are unstable. They combine to form molecules. Which means mass atoms exist as molecules. Elements, compounds, elements combine to form compound. So, all these are chemical combination and they are under chemical changes because new substances are formed. If no new substance is formed, then that is a physical change. Melting of ice block. Water has changed from ice, solid to liquid, but the identity remains. But burning, when you burn, a new substance is formed. Carbon dioxide is released and other gases, and you form ashes. The laws of chemical combination you should know are the law of definite proportion, multiple proportion, and conservation of matter. When we say something is conserved, it means that it remains. It is not created nor destroyed, although it can change from one form to another, which means I've already given you the law of conservation of matter. Gay-Lussac's law, Avogadro's law, chemical symbols, formulas, and equations. Relative atomic mass, isotopy. Masses of all elements are not whole numbers because of isotopy. When you see an atom with the same atomic number, they have different atomic mass. Chlorine, you have chlorine 37, chlorine 35. The same chlorine, different masses. That is isotopy. So how do we then calculate to arrive at the relative atomic mass of chlorine to be 35.5. Mole concept. What is mole? Mole is a fundamental quantity. And it is an amount of substance that contains as many elementary entities as there are 12 grams of carbon 12. Or any number that contains the Avogadro's number is the mole. What is Avogadro's number? You see, all these are connected. In fact, you can't really talk about one without indirectly thinking of the second one. 5 cm cube of carbon 2 oxide was exploded, boom, with 150 cm cube of air containing 20% oxygen by volume. Which of the reactants was in excess? As little as this question is, it requires a lot. 50 cm cube of carbon-2 oxide. They did not say carbon-3 oxide. They did not say carbon-4 oxide. They said carbon-2 oxide. And what is cm cube? Cm cube speaks of volume, which means volume of carbon-2 oxide. Volume is equals 50 cm cube. And volume of what? Of CO. Carbon-2 oxide is CO, also referred to as carbon monoxide. This was exploded with 150 cm cube of air, which means volume of air is equals 150 cm cube. And it says that this air contains 20% oxygen by volume. This air contains 20% oxygen by volume. So, volume of oxygen is equals 20% of 150 cm cube. Because the volume of air was 150 cm cube. And the volume of oxygen is 20% out of the 150 cm cube. Can we solve that? Percentage means over 100. So 20 over 100 times 150. This is 10 cancels 10. 10 cancels this. This will give you 30 cm cube, which implies that the oxygen in the air is 30 cm cube, and the remaining air or remaining volume is equals 150 cm cube minus 30 cm cube. This is equals 120 cm cube. So oxygen removed from the air, the remaining volume is 120 cm cube. Now, if carbon monoxide is exploded or is burning, when there is burning or explosion, we speak of oxygen, because oxygen is the part of air that supports burning. Oxygen is the component of air that supports burning. Air is a mixture containing nitrogen, about 78%, oxygen, about 21%, that is approximately 21%. You have carbon-4 oxide, about 0.03%, argon and other impurities. These are the constituents of air. But oxygen is what supports burning. If you remove oxygen from air, then you cannot burn. You can't burn without oxygen. So, carbon-2 oxide being exploded, it simply means reacting with oxygen, because it is that oxygen that we need for the explosion. What does that tell you? It simply means that carbon-2 oxide and oxygen, O2 molecule, are what we need for the reaction. Oxygen usually exists as a molecule. The atom exists as a molecule, O2. Now, I told you that stoichiometry explains what is and what should be. What is and what should be. If carbon monoxide reacts with oxygen, because I told you when you hear burning or explosion, they are just trying to tell you that react with oxygen. That's what they are telling you indirectly. If carbon monoxide explodes with oxygen, what is supposed to happen is that carbon monoxide plus O2 will give you CO2. Here we have one carbon. Carbon is balanced. Here is one. So 1 times 2, 2 plus 1, 3. We have 3 oxygen here. Here we have 1 times 2, we have 2 oxygen here. Oxygen is not balanced. to carry out stoichiometry, equation must be balanced. How do you know that an equation is balanced? The number of atoms here should be the same as the number of atoms on the other side. In that case, the equation is balanced. Since what is not balanced is oxygen. So how do we balance oxygen? Let's increase here. If we increase here, we have two carbon. If two carbon is here, here must automatically be two carbon. To make this carbon two, it is like this. So here carbon is two, carbon is two. Here oxygen is 2, 4. Oxygen is 2 times 2, 4, which means they are both balanced. Two carbon, 4 oxygen, 4 oxygen. Now add this to your dictionary. When CO and O2 react, this is the balanced equation. 2 carbon, oxygen and this. So if you see question like this again, you know that this is balanced. And after solving many questions, the ones that I said, you know how you see the balanced equation form. And in many cases, for complex ones, they will give you the balanced equation. They know that you have issues balancing the equation. Therefore, don't worry about how do I balance complex equations. Know all these simple ones. Complex ones, they will give you. Even in some questions, they will balance the simple equation for you. What's next? Let's deal with what should be. While dealing with what should be, you should know two things: mole and molar mass. What should be is that 1 mole of carbon monoxide must react with no. What should be is that 2 moles of carbon monoxide must react with 1 mole of oxygen to give you 2 moles of carbon 4 oxide. When you burn, carbon 4 oxide is released. So any burning that takes place, at the product side, there should be CO2. And at the reactant side, there should be oxygen. 2 mole of carbon, the number here is the number of mole. Here is 1. 2 moles of carbon monoxide is required to react with 1 mole of oxygen to give us 2 moles of carbon 4 oxide. Now let's see what happened. The volume of carbon monoxide is 50 cm³. If according to the reaction or according to the balance equation, 2 moles of carbon monoxide is required to explode with 1 mole of oxygen to give us 2 moles of carbon 4 oxide, it means using here should be 25 cm³, and here is also 2 moles. Here should be 50 cm³ in terms of volume. Since CO is 50, oxygen is supposed to be 25 cm³, CO2 is supposed to be 50 cm³. 50 cm³ of carbon 4 oxide was exploded with 150 cm³ of air containing 20% oxygen. And 20% oxygen in air is 30 cm³, which means they exploded 50 cm³ of carbon monoxide with 30 cm³ of oxygen. What does it mean? What we actually needed was 25 cm³ of oxygen, because this is half of this. We are given 30 cm³ of oxygen. It simply means that oxygen is in excess. If you are giving us 50 cm³ of carbon monoxide, if you are giving us 30 cm³ of oxygen, what should be here should be 60 cm³ of carbon monoxide. But you gave us 50 and you are giving us 25, which means oxygen is in excess by 5 cm³. The one that is in excess is the excess reagent. The one that is not enough is the limited reagent. So which of the reactants was in excess? Oxygen was the excess. If you ask which of them is the limiting reagent, the limiting reagent is simply the one that is not enough, that is carbon monoxide. There is another way this is usually asked that confuses students. They will tell you, what is the volume of the residual gas? If they ask you the volume of residual gas or what is remaining in the container, What is remaining in the container is the remaining air, volume of air, which did not react. That is 120 cm3. Then all the oxygen, all the carbon, 2 oxide reacted, nothing remaining. Then out of the 30 cm3 of oxygen, only 25 cm3 reacted, meaning 5 cm3 did not react. 5 cm3. Welcome to chemical combination and stoichiometry. The next episode, we fire on. So, that is it. Open your Flash Now Jam app, click on question search, type stoichiometry. Just glance at the questions. Glance at the questions. Don't solve yet. But if you see anyone that is very similar to this, solve. In the next episode, we move. Thank you.